Getting married.
Finally.
It took 3 years for this day, and we're finally here.
It's here, finally.
Well, I am completely, madly in love with him. He's amazing. He keeps me grounded, which I need, so.
Patrick swept me off my feet, showed me who I really was, and I really look up to him, and he is always there for me. And always pulling me in the right direction. And it's just, he puts up with me. No one else would. So I found someone who finally will do that.
Start this journey and this adventure with you. I know that we're gonna make a difference. I love you.
Still, you're not still. there's someone that I know you don't deserve. And if you were mine, I'd give the day everyone hurt you. I wanna try to live, it could live, it's all I've been thinking about. And the night came on when I heard that song, and I want to sing it again. I swear to every word you said, you wrote it once for me. Like it was a private joke, I know you never saw me. But I saw yours, and I'm on my own, will you be here? Let me stay. Can I be the one to go to God in love and story? Can I be the one? Can I be the one? How can I be the one? Oh, can I? Can I be still? Or did you sing it again? Or when you sing it again, can I be still? Or sing it again? Or when you sing it again, can I be still? Can I swear to you, everyone, you say you're always for me? Oh, like it was a private joke, I know you never saw me. Oh, when the light's over, and I'm on my own, will you be there? Will you be there? And I'll be the one to talk about the love you saw me. I'll be still. Oh, can I be still? Can I be still? Or can I be still?
You may be seated. Welcome, everyone. We are thrilled that so many of you could make it here today. One of the wonderful things about a wedding is that it also serves as a multi-family reunion, and it always pleases me to learn how far people are willing to travel to be here on a day like this, for an event like this, which just goes to show you how important it is to mark these happy transitions in our lives. We have guests here today from California, Maryland, Georgia, Texas, and New York. To all of you, welcome. Gavin and Patrick, thank you for traveling here today. One of life's greatest mysteries of how two people come to meet one another, how some magical and mystical spark is kindled within each of them, and especially how they happen to take the risk of giving voice to their private feelings. From ages forgotten and long before recorded time, humanity has rejoiced and offered prayers of hope and thanksgiving when two have found each other. Today, we gather here to stand as witness, to contribute to your public declaration of love. And today we join together to give our blessing to the joining of these two who have found each other. What makes this celebration today distinctly different is also a part of life's mystery. There's love, there's commitment, there are flowers, family and friends, music, and lots of caring people who have given up their day to be here. But the two among us who are pledging their devotion, loyalty, love, and responsibility are both of the same gender. This reality will increase the need for honest conversation. This reality will increase the need for showing respect to one another. This reality will increase the amount of responsibility you must take for and with one another. It is not easy for two people to love one another. It is not easy when they are both of the same gender. It is not easy to proclaim your affection, your attachment, or your bond openly, for many are not yet willing to see beyond their own fears and celebrate the love which we are witnessing here this evening. Yet you are doing it with candor and frankness. You are forcing new paths of growth for many, and we are touched deeply that you are joining your lives together. Remember that we are gathered here with you because we believe that you have the right to publicly declare and express your love. We are gathered with you because we honor and recognize the bond between you, and we stand with and beside you to assist in any way that we can. Now, Patrick has been one of my best friends for the past 20 years. Growing up with him has been an adventure, to say the least. Always trying to have every little aspect of his life planned out to the letter, which has led to some amazing parties and unforgettable memories. Unfortunately, too many to regale at this time. But one thing that has always been well known to the world is how much of a showman he is. I've never met anyone who has given more meaning to the phrase, all the world's a stage. You truly make the world what you own every day. Patrick has also had an immense love of amusement parks, especially Disneyland. I remember a video his parents showed me once of when Pat was about 2 years old at Disneyland, watching as the parade went by. While most kids would be waving at their favorite characters as they went by, he was behind the entire crowd having a parade of his own and couldn't be happier the entire time. But meanwhile, on the other side of the country, someone with the same larger-than-life personality was creating his own parades in the street for all the neighbors to see. Now, Gavin, from the moment I first saw you walking up with Patrick to meet me for the first time, I could tell without a question of a doubt you were someone truly special to him. I remember how excited he was when he first told me about you, and all of us here know that how giddy he can get when he talks about something he likes. Just going on and on and on about it. But this was different. The giddiness was still there, but it was from love. Now, obviously, I haven't known you nearly as long as I've known him, but I can still consider you a brother and my family. You've taught him something that I never thought possible, and that's patience. And I've witnessed that firsthand these past few days. You're an honest, kind, gentle, and faithful soul, and I am beyond honored to be helping you two finally tie the knot. The ceremony in which we are all now participating is a bold, even revolutionary act. As you all know, many in our society do not yet recognize the validity and worth of the holy union we today celebrate and affirm. Indeed, many are openly hostile to two persons of the same gender who decide to commit their lives to one another. We hope and pray that someday men who love men and women who love women will no longer feel the scorn of some. But in the meantime, we can express the joy and approval which we feel for Gavin and Patrick as they give public recognition to the love they feel for one another and the commitment they freely make to one another this day. Let me therefore ask those of you who have gathered here this day, do you who know and care for Gavin and Patrick give them your blessing now as they enter into this new relationship? And do you promise in the days and years ahead to give them your deepest love, understanding, and support during both good times and bad? If so, please say we do.
We do.
Alrighty. Now, do you two, Gavin and Patrick, promise to love, honor, cherish, and be faithful to each other, to care for each other in sickness and in health, through hardships and happiness, to share your joys and sorrows, your failures and successes, to help each other grow as individuals and as a couple, and to honor each other's goals and dreams and help each other to fulfill them.
We do.
Now, Gavin and Patrick have decided to write some of their own vows.
Thank you. Oh, yeah. All right. I did not write.
Oh.
It's
coming from the heart.
All coming from the heart. That's a good way of saying it. Patrick, you know, in this world, in our world, it's hard to find someone who will stick by someone from where they come from, what they bring with them. I brought a lot with me. And you put up with me. And you guided me. You've been there for me every day. And so many would just toss me aside, find someone else. But you stayed with me, and I don't know why. I asked myself that many times. After many tiffs that we've had, I said, this could have just ended today. He could have just left, started something else, starting something new. But you stayed with me, and we grew from it. We've grown so much in such a short amount of time. It's unreal. I can't wait to keep growing with you and be there for you during the lows and the highs. You've been there so much for me already. And I can't wait to keep going, keep growing. All right, I'm done. I can't keep this.
Oh, man. I thought this was going to be a lot easier.
Ugh. Right.
Gavin, we're here. We did it. It took a while, but we're here with family, with friends. I love you so much, and I cannot wait to spend the rest of my life with you. It's true that you have made me a better man. You have taught me how to love, and to love hard, and to realize my dreams, your dreams, our dreams. Thank you for letting me be me. And it's you and me, baby. It's you and me. And I cannot wait to spend the rest of our life together. And what we always say, Gavin and I, whenever we get into certain situations that are either awkward or just awkward, we always look at each other and say, the many adventures of Gavin and Patrick. So baby,
this is a big one.
The many adventures of Gavin and Patrick.
Yeah.
Oh, little Gavin, would you mind bringing me those rings? Got that okay, bud? Thank you. Alrighty. Wedding rings are a symbol of commitment and love. The rings are circular, like their love, with no beginning and no end. They represent what has been and what will always be. They are made of solid, sturdy material, which is meant to survive years and years of hand-holding, washing dishes, cuddling on the couch, vlogging, and many, many theme park adventures. Couples wear their wedding rings every day as a symbol of their love. And now, would you two please join hands? I'm gonna need one of those hands for just a second, though. Okay. Absolutely. Now, while you're putting this on, please repeat these words. I, Gavin, take you, Patrick.
I, Gavin, take you, Patrick.
To be my lover, companion, friend, and spouse.
To be my lover, companion, what was the rest?
Friend and spouse.
Friend and spouse.
I promise to love you and comfort you.
I promise to love you and comfort you.
To laugh with you and let you play.
To laugh with you and let you play.
And share your life.
And share your life.
Forever and always.
Forever and always.
And now, Patrick, would you please take this ring and repeat these words as you place it on his hand?
Oh, boy.
I, Patrick, take you, Gavin.
I, Patrick, take you, Gavin.
To be my lover, companion, friend, and spouse.
To be my lover, companion, friend, and spouse.
I promise to love you and comfort you.
I promise to love you and comfort you.
To laugh with you and let you play.
To laugh with you and let you play.
And to share your life.
And to share your life.
Forever and always.
Forever and always.
Tonight is all about love. It has been my absolute honor to officiate your ceremony this evening in the presence of God, family, and friends. And now I get to say something you've been looking forward to hearing, and I'm sure everyone here has been looking forward to hearing for a very long time. By the powers vested in me by the state of Florida, I now pronounce you for the first time ever, Gavin and Patrick Cooper. You may kiss your husband.
One by one, please give a round of applause to Lauren. Please welcome in Josh, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause for Fraca. We got three more, and the next one is Mike. Mike, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome in Victoria. last but not least, give a round of applause to Jonathan. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if you're capable to, please stand. And please give a huge round of applause, and it is my pleasure to introduce to you for the second time today, Mr. and Mrs. Gavin and Patrick Cooper. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mr. Gavin and Patrick Cooper, yeah. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated at this time. They've decided to go right into their first dance.
Thank you.
gentlemen, Mr. and Mr. Gavin and Patrick Cooper. Gentlemen, one time for the camera, give a big kiss.
Hello! Okay, so I'm doing a quick read around the room. I got a pretty good reaction. I only see a couple slightly confused and horrified faces, so that's good. For those of you that know Gavin and Patrick as well as I do, you know that they like to vlog in their free time, their daily life, the theme parks, and they start every episode with a nice, big, grandioso hello. So, if you don't know, you can follow them at youtube.com/GavinPatrick. Okay? You're welcome for that. And for those of you that don't know me, my name is Jonathan. I am not only their roommate slash best third wheel ever slash financial planner. And I had a starring cameo and a little video you may have seen on YouTube that had something to do with a proposal. I was one of the featured dancers. There was a nice big lift. Good, so most people saw it. Again, if you didn't see it, before the cake cutting, pull out your phone, youtube.com/GavinPatrick. Please make sure to subscribe, like, comment, share. They appreciate it. Hashtag Gavin loves Patrick. Okay, so, yes. So enough about me, let's talk about the happy couple. As I upstage them, something Patrick doesn't like. So, I first met Patrick back in 2005 when we went to school together in New York. We went to school for theater at a conservatory, which we'll rename nameless for many reasons. And we lived together after school. We lived in New York for almost 10, 11 years. We auditioned, we worked several jobs, and then one day we were just watching TV, and there was one of those annoying Walt Disney World commercials that you see so often, and we looked at each other and we joked and we said, what if we just moved to Disney World? And sure enough, here we are. We called each other's bluff, and here we are however many years later. So this is where Gavin comes in the picture. We moved down here to Orlando in about 2011. I think, Patrick, your first job was your Disney store and then also at the water parks. And for those of you that aren't familiar with Disney and the way they work, you got a lot of college program kids at the water park. So, and they're very well integrated. We'll leave it at that. They know each other very well. And the reason why, the reason I bring that up is because I guess Gavin and Patrick had a mutual friend. And the mutual friend said, hey, you guys would be great for each other. I know this guy, he's worked at Universal. I know this guy, he works at Disney. And so he introduced them to each other online via Facebook, of all places. And these two lovebirds, for whatever reason it took them so long, they did not meet each other for a year. They talked back and forth for a year before finally meeting one another. And this is where we get to the first date. Now, for those of you who've seen the proposal video, you can guess where the first date was. It was at... Perfect. Okay, good. I like this. Okay, so it was at Disney's Boardwalk Resort, and they ate at the ESPN Club for their first date. Now, again, if you know Patrick as well as I do, he's a picky eater. will not eat leftovers. Certain things can't have onion, sauce. For whatever reason, he thought a good, applicable first date food would be the PB&J burger with jalapenos from the ESPN Club. Anyway, the reason I bring this up is because Patrick described that burger as the most disgusting, heart-wrenching thing he'd ever eaten, but that he finished it because he wanted the date to go so well. And then, yes, yes. And in his exact words, he said, there's something different about this one. And he wasn't talking about the burger, he was talking about Gavin. So, yes, so just to be clear. And to get a little more sentimental, the past 2 years I've lived with them together, like I said, the third wheel, there are things that they've done together, they've lived together, they've learned together, they've love together. Unfortunately, they've lost together as well. And quite personally, there are some things that the two of you have been through that I don't know that I could personally do by myself unless I had somebody like one of you by my side. On that note, I have some advice I'd like to leave you with. Now, this advice is not for me. It's more so for you, Gavin, but it's applicable to you and maybe to whatever table's right there. In the words of a famous Emmy award-winning TV reality mogul / author / LGBT icon, again, Gavin, this is for you. You better work! And I mean that quite literally, you better work, because if you don't know anything about Patrick, you know that he has very expensive taste. There is no prenup. Again, congratulations to the both of you, and let's hear it again for the Coopers!
Hi, everyone. I'm Pat's dad, and I guess Gavin's father-in-law. Hey! Now, being Pat's dad has not been an easy thing, as any of you who know him. We've had our moments, but we love him dearly, and the same thing happened with Gavin. Gavin, we love dearly too. We were worried that Pat would never find someone who could put up with his attitude and, you know. All that. But enough prayer, you know, gonads and stuff like that. We found someone that wanted to take him up. So I said, hey, what the heck, we got what? $50 to lose? Nope. Pat is a great guy. He does have a temper when, you know, if things don't go his way, as Gavin can verify. But he loves his mom dearly, and she loves him. We just decided to move up here from California so we can spend time with him and make sure that he's okay and they're okay. And we're so glad that we're here now. We live one floor apart. Sometimes as I'm sleeping and I hear the front door open in the middle of the morning, and it's Pat coming down to take some coffee or cremora or eggs, raid the refrigerator for food. But hey, you get used to it after the first 400 or 500 times. But we love them dearly, both of them, and we're glad that they found each other, and they appear to be very, very happy. Thank you.
First day on Earth, I fell into your eyes. Look at how our galaxies collide. Every color of the spectrum, every star up in the sky, the planets aligned for you and I. Known you since the dawn of time, with twin flames burning bright. And I can't believe that I finally found you. Until the morning sun. Lay here forever. You and I together. I just wanna stay until the morning sun. I just wanna stay until the morning sun. and I'll never let you go. I'll never say goodbye. Together for eternity. Oh, I've loved you since the dawn of time. With twin flames burning bright, and I can't believe that I finally found you. I just wanna stay until the morning sun. Lay here forever, you and I together. I just wanna stay until the morning sun.
Cause nothing is better than you and I together. I just wanna stay until the morning sun. Lay here forever, you and I together. I just wanna stay until the morning sun.
Mr. and Mr. Gavin. Yeah.